A Winter's Promise, Book 1 of the Mirror Visitor series by Christelle Dabos, is a French fantasy, I guess it says young adult on the back, so I guess it is a young adult fantasy novel by a French author translated. This story wasn't particularly interested in it, but Emily Fox read it. She didn't give it a very high score, but I'm looking for books that are similar in the vein of Harry Potter, research for another video I'm working on. But basically, the Winter's Promise is about Ophelia. She is a young, bookish girl who lives on Anima. Anima is an arc. The world was split apart into these giant sort of, I don't want to say cities, but arcs are basically large masses of land. They're so big, though, that they have their own waterfalls and mountains. So basically like floating continents. And there's many arcs, too. So she lives on Anima. Her family lives with her. She has a very large family where everyone sort of knows each other. It's a big family. But she's got several powers, too. One is she has the ability to travel between mirrors in a short distance. The second being that she is a reader, meaning that when she takes off her gloves and she touches an object, she can delve into its past, previous owners. And so they have like a code and things like that. However, she is very nerdy, bookish, you know, introverted. She has already declined marriage offers arranged for her by her cousins. So, however, she gets one from a really large affluent family from the pole, which is like a really cold continent arc. So she sort of has to go into this arranged marriage with someone she's never met or heard of before, or else she faces banishment. So it's a pretty tight predicament for her, and she's sort of thrust into this, you know, new world because she's very naive. She's, you know, very, I don't want to say spoiled, but I want to say she's very sheltered in the fact that, you know, she's used to waking up with like several siblings and, you know, having toast with jam and butter, and she doesn't get to do all that in her new life because the person she's marrying is Thorn. Thorn is a tall, lanky man, no manners. You know, she doesn't like him immediately. But the more she finds out about him, the more sympathetic she gets about him. And then, of course, there's all this myriad of all these different characters. You know, there's tagging along Ophelia is her Aunt Rosaline, who's supposed to be her chaperone because, she can't leave her niece alone with her suitor for too long. They're not married. They have to do like an 8-month sort of thing where they live together. But they also have to try to keep this a secret because Thorn has lots of enemies because he is has a very special past that she finds out about. So there's a lot of there's a little bit of world building, not too much, but some magic systems that are thrown in there, and sort of political sort of shenanigans and like things like that, a lot of different characters. But our main character, Ophelia, is very reactive. She doesn't get to do much. She sort of gets slapped around a lot. Not the most pleasant read, to be honest, because it felt a little cold. There's something clinical about this book. It has everything you need for a fun fantasy adventure, but it doesn't feel fun. It feels perfunctory. You know, we got magic systems, we got powers, we got characters that are mean, we got, you know, suspense and disguises and things like that, but it just doesn't feel fun. I mean, they don't introduce the main antagonist until about like 300 pages into the book out of 500, and they introduce some more antagonists, but by the time they introduce these people, you know they're not going to like deal with them because it's so close to the end of the book. This book feels really short, even though it's 500 pages, doesn't give you much of a resolution. And overall, the book, you know, has all the elements you need, but it just doesn't gel well together because nothing really big particularly happens in the first book. There are four of these as well. The last two, I believe, just recently came out because of translation. But overall, A Winter's Promise left me a little cold. I mean, that's not a pun. I mean, she does go somewhere cold, but like, there's a lot of stuff going on, but it just doesn't feel fun. It just doesn't feel like it's connecting unless the next one does. But there wasn't really anything particularly I loved about it. Some of the side characters were fun, you know, but overall, it just kind of felt eh. So I give A Winter's Promise a 2.5 out of 5.